Hi, my name's Alex Walford. I'm a systems engineer, and in this short video, I want to show you how you can use Prometheus, which is a time series database that came out of SoundCloud, to monitor your processes that might span all kinds of different systems. In this case, I've pulled together an example using Kafka, some data from the OS, and a Java app. Now you'll notice that the arrows of these are pointing to the system. That's not a mistake. The Prometheus is basically scraping these systems. That's typically how it's used. And the thing that I really love about that is, imagine you have some rogue service. If the data was flowing the other way and you screwed something up, you could potentially give yourself a denial of service attack on the thing that is giving you visibility to what's going on. And you don't want that. So Prometheus will scrape all these endpoints in its own time, and it won't sort of blow itself up like that. That's very nice. So Kafka is a Java, or it's a JVM application. So we are using JMX, the Java Management Extensions, to collect metrics from Kafka. Not just Kafka, Kafka Connect too. So there's something called the JMX exporter. That's how that data is getting there. Now I would say that if you're going to run Kafka, you also need to keep an eye on your disk utilization. If you run out of disk space, you're kind of screwed. And so often you could be sort of blissfully unaware that you're sort of screaming towards disaster because you're not keeping an eye on disk usage. It's nice to put them both on the same dashboard, and then you can sort of see how the two things relate to one another. So in this case, I'm using the node exporter. This is pulling out all sorts of operating system metrics from CentOS, which is the free version of Red Hat. And, you know, I have a Java app. It's running on this little IoT device here. And I exposed a couple of gauges. These are called gauges. A gauge is like an a bounded measure. Think of it as like a speedometer. So in this case, I've got, you know, temperature and humidity. They're gauges. I put a couple of gauges within the app when Prometheus hits the endpoint for that IoT device. It will pull the result from those gauges. And so Prometheus has something called PromQL, Prometheus Query Language. And I think it's a really amazing and concise way of, you know, expressing queries on time series data. That's awesome. I would argue that the visualization is a bit weak in Prometheus, and it can be a source for Grafana. So in this case, I set up a Grafana. Grafana's kind of like the Kleenex of operational dashboards. It's pulling data out of Prometheus. So this is what we've got set up. Now, the first thing that I wanted to get into, and I'll try and do this in a fairly quickly so it doesn't get too far in the weeds, but look, if you're using the JMX exporter for some app, it's really useful to be able to see what metrics are available inside the app. And to do that, I used a tool called Visual VM. This is free, you can just download it, you have to enable a plugin called the mBeans plugin. mBeans is like manage beans. That's what has JMX metrics in it, and then you have to enable JMX, which in Kafka, it's as simple as export JMX underscore port. If you give it a JMX port environment property, then, you know, it will be listening for allow things to connect to that port and you know, see what's inside. And then you go off and you explore, and then you write some rules that are going to expose them. So I want to show you basically Prometheus is going to scrape. So if I go in here, look, this is what the endpoint that Prometheus is scraping. If I look inside here, I can see, you know, things like incoming bytes and that total number of incoming bytes. That's a metric. Maybe I want to track that over time, see how it's changed and what have you. Now, in order to do that, I had to go poke around in Visual VM. I pointed it at the Connect JMX endpoint. I poked around in here. Look, there's metadata that contains all the definitions for these things if you aren't sure. And here are the attributes themselves. And look, if I click refresh, you can see them updating. So this is what this is the data that Prometheus is scraping based on some regexes and what have you to determine what you want to capture here. So look, to attach the this Java agent, I have to attach this Java agent to a running process for Kafka. It's just Kafka ops, and then I added this to the systemd service definition. And look, it's here's the jar that contains the Prometheus Java agent, the JMX agent. I tell it the port, and then I tell it, here's a YAML file that contains some regexes of things that I'm interested in. All this stuff is online. I just wanted to give you kind of a high level of how that works. For other things, look, supposing I've got databases. Look, there's loads of different databases. I've got my Oracle, my MySQL, my SQL Server, Postgres, you name it. There are integrations already built that are going to pull out the most interesting and relevant metrics for you. Check this out. There's all kinds of different integrations in here, not just databases, tons of different, a lot of the work's already been done for you. So earlier on, I mentioned that we have PromQL, Prometheus Query Language. I just want to sort of touch on this, give you a sort of flavor of it. So in this case, you can divide ratios of things. So look, I got the file system size, for example, for this mount point, and I divided the free size by the total size, and that gives me total free. And then if I do 1 minus that, I get total used. So this is how I've got like disk utilization for all the nodes that I'm collecting data from. Then I'm doing a little bit of like search and replace on, and just to tidy up the labels a little bit in Grafana. So this is Prometheus. If I was to sort of start typing, so supposing I want to know something about Zookeeper, I could just start typing in Zookeeper in here, you can see these are all the metrics related to Zookeeper. So this is a handy way to explore what's available. Now this is my Grafana dashboard, and it looks a bit random, and I agree. It has some random stuff in there. And the point in this is that it ties things together from different places. So I would say that every business is going to have different things that are interesting to it, and they should all be visible in one place, and you should be able to make connections between things. So for example, if I have a topic that is creating a ton of data and my disk usage goes through the roof, I can see the time series and I can relate those two things. So I think that's really important to be able to tie things back to, maybe it's a checkout and you have, dollars in last hour or orders or number of customers currently logged in or, all kinds of different things. And I want to give you a very quick example of how you can measure weird things. So an example of this, look, I worked for this company, a while back. They're called KBM, Knowledge Based Marketing. This dashboard right here is driven from solar, and there was only one solar instance. So if you break it, this dashboard doesn't display, and people would get very angry with me. If there aren't colors on this, people would get angry. And so I wrote something that constantly logs in. So I used Selenium here. I have like a, I take a screenshot, right? So I log in to this website. I take a screenshot of this, and then I look at the colors on the screenshot. So you can go pixel by pixel and say, what are the most popular colors? And then I have a palette of the things, the colors that show up here. And then if those colors are not on my screenshot, I know I've got a problem. So these sorts of things, you could easily surface into Grafana. So that my point is really that when you're thinking about what to measure, you know, use a bit of imagination. Doesn't have to be something that is, you know, a named metric. You can design your own stuff, and I would recommend designing things that are really, really relevant to the business. So anyway, that was my quick overview of Prometheus and Grafana. I hope that was interesting. Thanks so much for watching.